Guys, and today I'm going to be reviewing Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2 in 3D. Before I start, I want to say I'm sorry that this review has been late, I've been quite busy. But anyway, on to the review. So Harry Potter Part 2, Deathly Hallows, Part 2 is the final Harry Potter film, which has been going on for a decade now. So that's pretty cool that it's finally ended, but it still feels pretty weird. You know, seeing them from number 1 now to number, 7 part 2. It's kind of strange. But, yeah, this one is in 3D, which I think was pretty disappointing because they should have kept all of the movies just in 2D, just because 3D is a new thing. I think everyone's going to watch the final Harry Potter. So they should have just left the whole saga in 3D. But, anyway, so it's basically about Harry, and he has to find the final Horcruxes to kill Voldemort. Yeah, I mean, 3/4 of this film is all in Hogwarts. The other quarter is in, like, Gringotts Bank and this cottage on a beach, which is in, like, in the first part. It's the first part, at the ending of the first part where Dobby dies. It's that cottage. And then, like, basically 3/4 of the film is all about Hogwarts, like, all the battles and stuff. Like, the effects and all the wand battles are amazing. I don't think this is actually the best, you know, Harry Potter film. Although it was absolutely brilliant and awesome, I think it's probably like the second best, maybe. I still think the fifth one is the best for me, in terms of effects and acting. But, you know, this one is really good. I really highly recommend this. And it is the final Harry Potter, so, you know, get your handkerchiefs out. No, I'm just kidding. But, no, seriously, really, really good effects and everything. Really, really awesome. So it's finally ended. Harry Potter Part 2, Deathly Hallows. Yeah, definitely go watch it. So, yeah, this is my review of Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2. Yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you later.